Welcome again to Cass, West Virginia. This is Railroad Special number 15. This special differs in the fact that we have a Heisler locomotive, number 6. Locomotive number 6 there is the Heisler. And there it is one more time. This is it. Here is a front view of the Heisler. The difference is this locomotive has a central drive shaft in the middle underneath, not on the side, like the chaise. You'll see it in detail later. Preparing for the day's run. But first, we will see something called the pace sequence. This is Heisler number 6 again. Here we are at Leatherbark Run, the first of a series of run-bys. The Heistler will be one of the pushers behind the caboose. Crosses Back Mountain Road. The train is now blowing its whistle for a side road up the mountain. Our train is now arriving at the first switchback. That's the track you see to the right there going up the mountain. It helps the train gain elevation rapidly. The train has now reversed and is backing up the switchback. There is one more switchback further up. We are now waiting for the logging train with the Heistler locomotive to come up to the switchback. And I think I hear it coming. By the way, we are now at Limestone Cut. And here it is from around front. Still at Limestone Cut. And once again, the Heisler. We have now arrived at the second switchback. This is the 11% grade. The track puts again to your right. The train will back up to the spur track and then pull forward on the switchback. And there's the track right there. Or there it was, anyway. Our train is now preparing to go up the second switchback. Then the logging train with the Heisler will follow. This is mountain railroading. just waiting for the other train to catch up. Logging train has just cleared the switchback and is now about to proceed up the 11% grade just like our train did. And at the front of the train, as already mentioned, Heisler number 6. Just thought you'd like to see some of the terrain that the railroad passes through. Here are some mountain scenery. Yes, this is West Virginia. We are now approaching Whittaker Station, the first of the two stations. stand once again, waiting for our logging train to catch up. Here's the logging train approaching Whittaker from a different angle. And heading the train, Heisler number 6. And here's number 6 again. We are now proceeding up Back Allegheny Mountain. At its peak, its elevation is 4,842 feet. That is Bald Knob, the highest point that we will reach today. up at another mountain view. We have now made it to Oats Run water stop. It is raining a little bit, but we're still taking on water. We have finished taking on water, and now our train departs. We are now at the Y track, waiting for the train to catch up to us again. That's how it works. The logging train follows the photographer's train. Interesting pacing sequence. By the way, the rain stopped. We are now heading for our highest point, bald knob. And our train is arriving at Bald Knob right now. And soon will be the logging train. This is the second highest point in West Virginia. Let's now watch as the logging train makes a spectacular entrance. This is one of the steepest grades on the railroad as well. Well, we are now at Bald Knob. This is the second highest point in West Virginia. From here you can see clear into Virginia as well, over the furthest mountain in the distance. Our elevation is 4,842 feet. Only certain plants can grow this high up. Have another look around. That is shay number two. And apparently, some people are still playing with the Heisler. This locomotive here is the Heisler, once again. Notice it does look different from the chaise. C same in principle, though, just different in construction and design. Notice a single drive axle underneath there. Let's walk over to the overlook and we'll show you what the view looks like. Well, in a few moments anyway. This is the train that brought us here, the photographer's train. The logging train followed us up the mountain. This is the overlook at elevation 4842. This is the view from the overlook. What you see there is the area that we came from, believe it or not. This train climbed 2,500 feet to get to where we are now. That's the direction of Baltimore, northeast. Virginia is over the far mountain. And once again, farms at the bottom there. You must see this place in person. Video does no justice for it. That's all I can say. That other locomotive was the Shay that you've seen before. Preparing to depart Bald Knob. First, the logging train begins backing down, and then we will. And here is another one of our many run-bys. This one is not too far from Whitaker Station. We are now backing down. Only for the sake of sound effects, our locomotives will be pulling forward so you can hear them work. Okay. Let's try the same shot, but from a different angle this time. Heisler number 6. Okay, we're back at Leatherbark Creek again. This time from a different angle. And now we're going back to the station. How about one more run by? Why not? Thank you. we are now making our way back to the station. Here are some other equipment Cass owns, and we'll restore pretty soon. That was number 5, taking a breather. And here we have the original wooden water tank. The ruins on the left were the lumber mill ruins. We are now entering the main line of the Scenic Railroad, or so it was before they abandoned it back in 78. Think they heard us? And so ends this ride on the Cass Scenic Railroad. The date is October 16th, 1989. Beautiful day in the mountains of West Virginia. The sound is brought to you in hi-fi stereo, as will be from now on. Yes, there is a zoo there too. And up ahead, last but not least, Castle Station. Hope you enjoyed your ride. See you next year. Oh, by the way, this is exactly how the town looked 100 years ago. The town once again, and that's it.